Hello, everyone. I hope you guys are enjoying the Forward Show. Just a quick reminder, any donation to the, that goes to the Forward Show will go directly to SMILE, supporting and mentoring youth advocates and leaders. I'm very excited to be speaking with a guest from SMILE just to learn a little bit more about the resources they offer. So welcome, Hansi. If you don't mind just introducing yourself, tell us a little bit about yourself and include your pronouns.
Hi, Nico. Thanks so much for having me on the Forward Show. I'm Hansi Stokes. I am the communications manager at SMILE, and my pronouns are she, her. So in my role at SMILE, I manage our social media, our email communications, media communications, de facto video producer, really taking on a lot of that, especially in this last year with, you know, all of the virtual work that we've been doing. But also what I really love about doing communications at our organization, since we're a small organization, is I really get to work with every department that we have, with our drop-in programs team, with our housing team, with our development and executive director. So kind of do a little bit of all of it, which I love because I really love community. That's part of the reason why I work at SMILE. So I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, well, thank you for coming in. If you don't mind just giving a quick summary about SMILE and some of the goals for the organization.
Sure. So as you said, SMILE is the shorter acronym for Supporting and Mentoring Youth Advocates and Leaders. And we were founded in 1984 here in Washington, D.C. We've got offices on Capitol Hill, and we've also got some housing programs scattered around the city. But at our core, we are an LGBTQ youth empowerment organization that core has stayed with us for all, I guess that would be 36, 37 years now that we've been around. And we do that by a couple different programs. We have our general drop-in center programs, which are designed to build community, to build youth leadership, and really just provide a space for young people to gather in person when there wasn't a pandemic and now virtually, so that we can prioritize health. But we also have a really robust housing program that serves LGBTQ youth who have experienced homelessness. And we actually just opened our third housing site, which is really exciting.
Oh my God, that's so cool. I was actually about to bring up your housing program. And also, if you could tell me a little bit, can you tell me a little bit more about Little Smiles?
Oh, definitely. So I'll start with our housing program. From our inception as an organization and across the country, homelessness is one of the largest issues facing our community, LGBTQ youth to adults. When SMILE was kind of taking a look at where our work should go next, especially as, you know, in our city and some of the surrounding communities became more affirming, that housing issue was still one of the greatest needs. So we opened our first housing facility in 2017, opened a second facility in 2019, and just opened our third facility actually earlier this week. And so we're now able to serve 38 youth, and those residencies range from 2 years up to 6 years. And they really provide youth with a range of life skills support, employment navigation, helping get folks connected to education, if they're continuing education, and really building a path towards independence. So that's our housing program. It's one of our proudest programs.
Oh my God, that's incredible. That is, as a fun queer youth, as the kids said, I knew so many queer kids who had either been had like rocky relationship with their parents or like had just full blown been kicked out. So like, it's amazing the services you guys are offering. What are some of the benefits that queer youths have like in terms of having access to a community center?
Yeah, so in terms of having a community center, you know, SMILE started just as like a circled up group of chairs. Like, I really love that history. And obviously since then, things have grown so much, but still having a physical space to gather with other people, to really see that you are not alone, I think is one of the biggest benefits of having a community center, that you're able to share space with people about you know, either just your daily life or what it's like to be queer. And as we've kind of moved over to a virtual community space now, we're still able to have some of those conversations. You know, I think a lot of us really miss out on, you know, we used to have Vogue nights on Friday nights. We'd have like movie nights as well. But we're still finding a way to find that community online. And so like our virtual platforms have become that center.
I was actually about to ask. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I was actually just about to ask about your virtual sort of offerings that you guys have.
Yeah, definitely. So we're coming up on a year since we went virtual. So our drop-in programs we were doing in person every Tuesday through Friday night, and we were trying to figure out a way to transfer that over to a virtual space. And so we tried out Zoom for a long time, but we found that a lot of youth didn't really, I mean, like most of us had Zoom fatigue. They were in school doing it all day. So because young people are on the cusp of every technology, we've moved over to Discord servers. And so it's kind of this ongoing chat platform. So we still have dedicated program times, but there's that server that youth can log on during our programs, talk about the topic for the day, connect with each other, build friendships. We still do some of our programs on Zoom so that you still have some of that face-to-face interaction, but our virtual programs are mostly over chat now. And then last summer, because we also host a youth leadership conference that's typically in person, we moved that virtually as well. And so that became a week-long conference and we held that all over Zoom, which was really cool because while we're based in DC, now that we're virtual, we can actually reach people across the country and across the world. We had people log into that program from California, from Canada. And a lot of that has continued over just into our regular programs as well.
That's awesome. That's so crazy. Oh, I love that. So a little more about these chat rooms. Do you have to provide any sort of information in order to join any of these events?
Yeah, so we do have a registration form. Part of that is for safety, that you know, you can't just get full access to our platform without kind of signing in. And that's also for us to, you know, get the contact information for youth so that we can let them know of our other programs going on. So we ask for name, pronouns, email address, just some kind of, and like where you're located, but all of that stays internal. We don't require parent or guardian permission for most of those programs. The only one that we do is our Little Smiles program, which is for ages 6 to 12, just because of the age of the youth that
yeah,
we want
of course.
Their parents' consent for that. But we really focus on this being a safe and supportive space and an affirming space for youth when they join.
Yeah, of course. So I would assume you guys have a moderator for all the chat rooms.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So we have a really incredible programs team. Addison, who is our drop-in center manager, runs all of the chats. We also have some other folks who help facilitate. And then we have a few youth fellows, which are paid interns who work with us for a year. And so Addison has a drop-in center youth fellow who helps facilitate those programs.
Okay, awesome. Great. Yeah. So what kind of chat rooms do you guys have?
Yeah, so they've changed throughout the year depending on just kind of the need and what spaces people are looking for. So following the Black Lives Matter protests last year, we created a space to talk about race and had, you know, support spaces, anti-racism spaces, and that's kind of evolved. And then we also had a space that was specifically dedicated towards trans and non-binary youth called Dealing with Delays, which we created when hospitals were not performing what they deemed elective service or elective surgery. So a lot of gender affirming care was kind of put on hold for a while.
Yeah.
Those things have since opened up. So our programs are a bit more general now, but the topics change week to week. So we have dedicated spaces for trans and non-binary youth, BIPOC youth, bi and pan youth. We've got a young adult chat space for 20 to 24 year olds. We have a kickback night, which is kind of just like our game and movie night. We play a lot of Jackbox games. And then we also have a program called Community Deep Dive. So we choose a topic and kind of just go headfirst into it and really have those in-depth conversations.
Awesome. So what are you guys doing to keep the all the virtual events like safe and secure, aside from obviously moderators?
Yeah, so the moderators are kind of the biggest part of that, and really ensuring that we have kind of set community standards when you join our group. So if someone starts to talk about something maybe triggering, it's not necessarily you get kicked out of the group, but there's, you know, we kind of pull them off to the side, AKA start a direct message with them.
Oh, yeah, and they give them like a warning, right?
Exactly. And kind of talk about it similar to what we would do if we were in the space, if there are threats being made in the space. And luckily, we haven't really had anyone who's tried to breach our servers, which is amazing. But we do calls in place just in case there is something going on. But we really strive to have kind of that upfront, you fill this form out. We kind of do like a little bit of an identity check in terms of like, we monitor and make sure that like, it's clear that someone is not out of our age range, or that someone is trying to cause harm by bringing up certain topics, or, you know, spewing hate or anything like that. So it really comes down to, we at least have two moderators in any chat so that, you know, people can be focusing on the larger chat, and then someone can kind of pull somebody aside in the direct message.
Okay, awesome. So I'm sure there's some people who are nervous about coming into a community center like this, like Smile. So like, do you have any resources or words of wisdom to make you more comfortable before diving right in?
Yeah, so I definitely look at this virtual world as, I think it lends itself a little bit better to people who might be shy about coming to a space like ours, or nervous, because there is a safety to being behind a computer screen, right? You don't have to get on the metro and come to our like physical space. You can log out anytime you feel overwhelmed. What I would say is that try it, you know, kind of dip your toe in. You get to control how active you want to be in the chat, or how kind of like, if you want to kind of just like play it safe for that chat. But know that the people who are running the programs are there to affirm you, to answer any of your questions, to help you find resources if maybe we're not the right resource for you. And that there are other young people who want to have those conversations and build those relationships and build friendships. And it's totally up to you. I mean, part of our goal with youth empowerment is that we trust young people to know what's best for them. And so if this space is right for you, we welcome you. And if it's not the right space for you, we'll help you find another place that might be.
All right. Okay. Well, thank you so much for talking with us. Do you have anything to add right before we wrap things up?
The biggest thing that I would say is I'm really glad that shows like The Forward Show exist, focusing on young queer people. You know, young people need to be included in conversations about the LGBTQ community and the movements we're involved with, because we're not just leaders tomorrow. Young people can be leaders today.
Oh, of course. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming in and joining us. I guess everyone enjoy the Forward Show. Enjoy the rest of it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.
Bye.